The other news is on China and U.S. trade talks in Beijing. And then the Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross on Squawk a few moments ago talking about that Apple warning from last week and whether or not it was truly due to conditions in China. Take a listen to that.
Well, I don't think Apple's earnings miss had anything to do with the present trade talks. Think about it. There have been no tariffs put on Apple products, so that's not it.
That raised some eyebrows this morning, Jim, considering that Apple did specifically cite conditions in China.
Yeah, I love Wilbur Ross. He's super. Here's the problem. If you're a Chinese consumer, it's really conspicuous to buy an American phone right now. I think that just like we have America first from our president, there is a China first. The Chinese phones aren't that bad. I think it has to do with cyclical economy a little bit worse, but also the idea of when I show up at a store, I really want to show pride. Showing pride does not mean buying Apple products, even as Apple makes a ton of products there. I just wish that it were so simple as to say, you know what, there are no tariffs. There's nothing to do with tariffs. It has to do with being a conspicuous buyer of an American product at a time when there's a real trade war. And I don't think the Communist Party wants to see that.
Of course, the other news on Apple today is this deal with Samsung, in which they will add an app to their smart televisions that would allow owners to watch content that they bought on iTunes. And given the history with those two companies, Jim, some say it's a bit of a landmark.
Oh, I think you're so right. I've been pondering this all night and thinking to myself, well, wait a second. Apple has been going it alone. Samsung, obviously, Android. For so long, and now they're number five in China, maybe something's happening to say that the Apple universe wants to be a little bit more open. I think that it needs to do that if they're going to be able to regain earnings momentum.
Will they really be able to regain earnings momentum, Jim?
You know, David, it doesn't trade like an earnings momentum stock. I mean, it doesn't trade like Amazon, doesn't trade like Netflix. It trades as if it's a consumer product stock, except for it sells at half the multiple of Clorox. Clorox grows 1 to 2%, maybe 3% in a good year. If this company were followed by a consumer products company, then I think that what you would, analysts, I think you'd see a substantially higher stock. David, it's been a value stock forever because people feel it has no growth. I think it has tremendous innovation, and I'm really tired of hearing that it's just left behind. The China issues are real, but the idea that Apple is somehow and also ran worldwide is preposterous. They have great numbers in America. It's just that the stock trades like a value play. It should be trading like a growth stock. And as long as it's this cheap, I think it's fine.